bed at 6 p.m. last night. I didn't get much sleep the night before, probably like 5 hours, not smart, and I was just really tired and lagging on energy and just like sleeping in weird positions, so my body's feeling like tight in certain areas, so I wanted to work kind of just on some mobility of the body. You know, if you've been like sleeping in, on the same side, you know, the shoulder might be a little, you know, in pain in your scap area. So just working the controlled articulation, cars basically. So I'm excited, let's get started. We're gonna start with our scap, kind of in an all fours quadruped position. Hopefully you guys can see me all right. So I want you to think about, you're on your all fours, and you know, sometimes we just like let the ribcage go and just like kind of have our back arch. I want you to really press the floor away with the palms of your hand, right? So that you're really engaged up here. You can balance like a glass of wine on your back and not have to worry about it falling, right? So we're gonna go. Actually sink down, roll the shoulders backwards up, and repeat. They're kind of just like, we're focusing on the serratus, which is right underneath here. And you just wanna like let, it is not the neck dropping, so don't think let the neck drop. You really have to think about this upper ribcage area relaxing and rolling. Using your shoulders. Give me two more here. I'm not really good at them, so the slower you go, the better. Down, up, and push the floor away. Now let's reverse. Down, forward. I guess my shoulders are going backwards. So backwards. Just reverse, right? So we let our chest drop, shoulders push around, and then you push the floor away. Hopefully you can see what's happening in my thoracic upper back area. Two, last one. Cool, all right. From here, I want you just to start to take the arm behind the head and just start to open, keeping a gaze with your elbow. Yeah, really lifting. Really try to open up that thoracic spine area. Ooh, your back might pop. That's okay. You can start to use your full arm. So we're really just trying to isolate the thoracic spine and really trying to work on its mobility. That's kind of the focus for today. Good, roll the shoulders up, back and down, reset. Make sure you're also pressing weight through the tops of the feet, right? Really actively holding your core together, kind of everything we've been working on, just don't be like sitting around like this, right? All right, take the other hand behind the head. Take it down. Twist and rotate, 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 so you can't anymore, but don't let your form go, right? Form is really important here. This will really help if you are, now, when you're balancing on this hand, don't collapse into it, really keep it activated and engaged in your shoulder socket area. This will really help if you've been feeling like you've been sleeping the same sleeping position and you feel all tight but not mobile, this will really help. Follow the hand with the eyes. You're really rotating in the trunk. Two more. And one. Good. Let's take it to a child pose. Open up the knees, toes are together. You really sit your weight backwards. You really want to try to get your booty all the way towards your heels. Feeling that lower back lengthen. Similar thing here, take your arm, thread it through. Make sure the shoulders stay even. It's not about how far you can go through, it's just keeping that form. Good. And kind of push back down and open up. So you can reach even further. Good, coming back to center. Other side, follow your hand through. Stretching the shoulder meets the arm. Good, guys, coming back up. Oh, you guys are feeling a little bit more open here. Yeah, we're gonna work on our hip mobility now. So I want you to think about 90 degrees. So start making 90 degrees with your hips. Your hip might be up a little bit, that's okay. We're going opening up the hip area. So what I want you to do is make sure that both hips are making a 90 degree angle. Plant your hands behind you. And using the outer part of your thigh, I want you to start the rotation. Keep the front leg down and push as far until that last moment it needs to come up, right? Now we're gonna sit equal between both sit bones and you're just gonna rotate, pressing down, 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 down. This will help you with your pigeon pose. I'm gonna do it one more time to the front and then I'm gonna do it to the side because I don't really want to be legs open. But to show you guys what it should look like. So think about pressing through that left hip. Right now I'm sitting on my right hip. My shin is making a 90 degree to my hip bone. Put your arms behind you, keep the chest open. Remember, you start with the outer thigh, push up. I don't know why my music keeps changing, but keep weight. Don't let this front leg pop up. Open, 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 open until you can't anymore. Make sure both feet are flat on the floor. You're feeling this opening, and then rotate that front leg. All right? You really feel the hips opening it up. All right, so outer thigh, both. Front, down, up, up. Two more, up. Keep that leg on the floor until you can't anymore. All right, you wanna keep contact on both sit bones. Yep, and this will, like I said, help us into our pigeon. So let's hang out here for a second. Sit up really tall between both hip bones. All right. And just think about elongating your thigh. You know, try to get it behind you a little bit more. Take your hip, push it down to the floor. It's okay if you're up here and you need to use your hands, you know, but as you do that, you find length in that hip socket, right? So nice and tall. I don't like to stretch statically when we haven't been increasing our heart rate. So I don't want to hold this too long. I don't want to get into any craziness. But that's kind of how you're going to get into your splits or your pigeons or anything like that. You wanna think about keeping those hip bones, your sit bones, everything really grounded to the floor when you're rotating, right? Now, like I said, it's okay if it's not to the floor right now as long as you're focusing on that hip bone rotation. So pull that knee in, let's go to the other side. Starting with your back hip, lift it up, lift it up, lift it up. See, my leg is still making contact till it can't anymore, and then we rotate, 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 rotate. All right, I'm sitting up nice and tall. We're really trying to anchor down my left hip bone. My front shin is parallel to the mat. Pick your knee up. We're kind of just in lengthen throughout the thigh bone area. Yep, can you take that hip bone and now rotate it to forward, right? So remember, it's okay if you're up here, but really just trying to find length in that hip socket. Your hip flexor. Feels good. I like to sleep on my sides or on my tummy. Tummy is probably the worst sleep for your body. Bring that knee in. Whew. Yeah, sleeping on your tummy is probably the worst because you have to sleep with your neck rotated on one side to breathe. You know, you can't put your face in the mattress or you're gonna die. You're gonna suffocate yourself, right? So you're sleeping in this twisted position, right, when you're laying on your tummy, and it can really tighten up your shoulder and neck area. I like to sleep on my sides, which means I stay bent. I'm like this, so sometimes my knees really, you know, all this tension that I'm holding in my hip flexor area, it's really tight when I sleep. So it's really important to try to lengthen that out. Cool. I hope we're feeling a little bit more loose and in our bodies. Gonna bring up the heat a little bit. Ugh, how's everybody doing? I hope we're doing well. Hey, Gabby. Hey, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. So right now, we just worked on our body a little bit of mobility, you know, waking up the body, really talking about when you're sleeping in those positions for long periods of time. Trying to hold those stretches too long without being warm. We're gonna do a little compound series. Get the body warmed up and strong. Hello, Sammy. Hi, I hope you're doing well. Yay. Hi, Kasan. mantra. Great, guys. Okay. So, we're just gonna start in a plank, right? Ribs are engaged, they're locked in, nice and strong. We'll need to spread out your feet hip distance apart. All right, we're gonna do some shoulder taps. The name of the game is trying to be as stable as possible without rocking side to side as much, right? So when you lift up one arm, you have to center the weight between those three things on the floor. So give me up and up, press away. Four more, go four. Three, keep that core tight, press through the feet too. And one, hips up, stretch it back. Really try to anchor your heels on the floor. Roll through the body, take it back up. Roll through the body. So we're gonna take it across for two, rotate passe derrière, extend, and down. All right, so that was across the body, knee to elbow. Rotate from that hip bone, passe derrière. Don't let your knee hang. Really use your glute, your outer glute, extend. And down, downward dog. So we're doing some outer glute work. You really have to not let that knee drop. As you cross mountain climb, take that knee and that glute and really pull it open. Extend and drop it down to a plank. Okay, we're gonna do one more on each side. Strong plank. We go, cross the body. Across for two. Right here, rotate from the hip socket. Keeping the hips even. One more time. Rotate, 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 rotate. Okay guys, so now we're gonna add a push-up, a shoulder tap into the cross. Passe derrière extension. Okay, it's a compound raise. Go slow. Control your breathing. Center everything right here. You have a push-up to start. Here we go. Down, up, tap, tap, across. I said slow, but I lied. Down, up, other side, cross, cross. Mountain climb, rotate, extend. One more time, each side. Keep that neck and chest long. Last one. Tap it left, tap it right. Across, rotate. Knees down. Child's pose, let that forehead relax. Turn the palms up to the sky. Roll up, one vertebrae at a time. Open those shoulders. I know I said slow, but I lied. If that was challenging for you, take them two counts. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Two, three, four, cross, five, six, open, seven, eight. One, two, three, four. Okay, I hope we're doing well. Great, guys, so you should be really in your body, building up a little bit more heat. I want you to put your socks on and have some space. Try not to be on carpet. If you can be on hardwood, concrete, tile, anything that you have. We're gonna keep this one nice and short today. Short, like 20 something minutes. All right, so you should feel in your body, loose. We're gonna do some sliding work with our socks. So your socks act like sliders. Have you ever been like moving furniture and you slip a slider into the furniture so you can push it? Same concept. So meaning that you have to keep weight on your feet for this to work, right? If I'm not pushing anything down as I am extending, what's the point? It's kind of like a Pilates reformer. If you have ever done Pilates, you'd be standing on the board. there would be a bed behind you that you can push, right? With the springs and stuff. So we're just gonna start going down and coming up. Now, as you go down, use this back leg. As you come up, use your supporting leg, right? You can add some arms to make this a little bit more dynamic. Now, if you are a dancer, even if you're a trained dancer and you want a more of a challenge, take those arms down, come to a supporting passe, right? So we take it down and up. Using the crown, staying long with the crown of the head, pushing and growing. Now, if you're not a dancer and you don't feel comfortable, just pull it in. See if you can pick that foot up just a little bit. Now, as our arms come overhead, it's gonna be really easy to open the chest and splay the back, right? Or splay the chest, arch the back. Try to keep everything together as much as you can, right? Good, from here, arms come in. You push out and in. You have most of the weight on your supporting leg. Don't know what's happening with the music, but I'm glad we actually have music today. You should be really feeling this in that supporting leg. Push back and in. Give me four more. Four, three, stay low. Get that bottom even lower to the floor. Two, one. Stand up nice and tall. How are we feeling? That supporting leg should be on fire. Let's do the other side. You're just coming to a high lunge. Down and up. You have to have weight on that foot going out. And now think about that supporting leg, pulling it back in. Keeping the core together. Pull your legs into the midline of your body. So I don't want to see your leg out here. I don't want to see your leg over here, not yet. I want to see it as far back. Can you have a single leg, right? Can it come right next to the other leg, that midline? Start to add your arms down. If you want to be a little bit more challenged, as you come up, find a stacked, aligned passe down. Or you can just give me a high knee, but think about your core lifting that leg up. I have a slight hinge in my hips, and my gaze is down and out. I'm trying to pull my arms all the way up to my ear. So think bicep to ear, right? It's not here, it's not out here. Kind of that line. Give me two more of these. Now even though I'm at a diagonal hinge, I want to think about keeping that and then coming to stack. Good, last time. Pull those arms in. Good. So go out and in. Sink lower into the ground on that supporting leg. The core pushes it back and in. Four, three, two, and one. Okay, so it's a little bit more fired up. Whew, I hope we're doing well. We're gonna hit the floor. Good, Sammy. Burn, burn, burn. Get that body moving. Taking it to the floor, same concept. You have weight between both feet. So we're not gonna be on our mat for this. All right, it's all about the abs. We're just gonna take it to a mountain climb. Go in, in. Really hunch in the core. Not in the shoulders, but really firing up the core. Double time. In, in. Maybe not go out back as far. Keep it tight. Eight more. Open chest. Four, three, two, one. Take it out. Now take it up and out. So what's happening in here is I'm hiking the hips. Key here is I have to shift my weight over the hands and use my lower abdominals to hike my hips. My weight will slightly go forward, kind of like a chaturanga, where in a plank, you shift your weight forward to then come down, All right, if we're doing a push-up flow, same concept, okay? Let's do 8 planks. Whew. So when you're in your plank, yes, you're on hand, hand, foot, foot, but as you start to pike, transfer the weight into the hands and let the legs slide up, using your core and your back articulating its spine, okay? Catch your breath, close the ribcage in, nice and tight. Okay. Inhale, shift the weight forward. Core. One more. job, guys. Let's end taking some breaths. Inhale up. Take as much space as you can. Exhale. Articulate that spine. Inhale up. Contract down. Really good work today. I liked how we started the week off kind of simple. Maybe not simple, but pretty effective. Anytime you're feeling stiff in the body like that, after like a nice long sleep, stretch your body side to side. Yeah, really cool. One more inhale, take it up. Collect all that positive energy. Roll it up. Nice work. Yay. Day one of week five, done. I told you I wanted to keep it simple, but effective. So this really helps you get into your body, get to know your body a little bit better, like I was talking about. Yes, we know how to work our hamstring, quads, glutes, those big muscle groups, but very rarely do we get to focus on the stability muscles. There's so many, there's hard to name them all, but whoop, whoop. Good job, girl. This will really, really help you get into your bodies better. You are so welcome. Tomorrow, we're gonna amp it up a little bit, kind of pick up where we left off with the body strength, and then take it to the next level with some jumping, with some plyometrics, just to get us to the next level in our bodies.